in the city of Slonim.
Sod HaVod is not the same thing as your Shor
HaVod. No, no. Sod HaVod is a big organ, but not Slonim. Slonim is the Sod HaVod. After the Slonim Rebbe, the Sod HaVod was Nifter, his son, Michel Arn, took it, was not able, he was a very on-off, a very simple Poshtim, and he said he cannot be a Rebbe. So the Sod HaVod gave it over to his grandchild, the Rebbe Chayov, he shows it to him, he wants, he should be the Mamshich. It was the Divrei Shmuel, Rebbe Shmuel Weinberg, the Rebbe, the Divrei Shmuel, that he took over also in this, in Slonim. And Divrei Shmuel had two sons. One was the Beis Avrom, but he continued the Hasidus in Branovich. And the older brother was Rebbe Yisrochel Leib. He was Slonim Rebbe, not the big Oilom. Went to the younger brother, Beis Avrom in Branovich. And the older brother left in Slonim, but it was very together. Cholile was no machloikes, they used to come together, but the Yortzal, the Sod HaVod, was very love each other. This was the Emshach, the Beis Avrom. The Beis Avrom had only one son, Ben Yochi, your daughters, but the son was only one, Reb Shloime Dovid Yeshua. Shin Dalet Yud, Shloime Dovid Yeshua, Rosh HaTeves Shin Dalet Yud. He was Rebbe only 7 years. He was the son-in-law from the Alexander Rebbe, and they was left in Branovich, and the Holocaust came, was killed, Al Kiddush Hashem, in Branovich, by the Holocaust, and he and his wife, his little daughter, and the father-in-law, the Alexander Rebbe, and with no Hemshach. It was the last finish from this in Branovich. But the younger Rebbe, we call it younger Rebbe, Shloime Dovid Yeshua, he was killed by the Nazis. So, I had a chance 20 years ago, Bishnas Tov Shin Nun Gimel. I was, the first time I was visiting in Poland, in Warsaw, also in Russia. What was the reason that I was able to visit in this place? Because my family, from my father, Doris grew up in Minsk, Belarus, Minsk. And my father, when he was old, 17 years, a young boy, the Bolsheviki came up and was terribly zealous against the Yidden. No Torah, no Chassid, nothing. So he left his parents, his father, his mother, his family, and he ran away from there, 17 years old, the boy, to Berlin, to Germany. He said he's going to study, he ran away to he should be a Yid, save a Yid. And his father and the whole family was killed in Minsk with all the Yidden in the ghetto Minsk. This was, my father was able to leave in time, and this is the, we exist, we so what I heard, that the sister of my father, she survived. She was a partisan in Minsk, and she survived. And she left a daughter, which is my cousin, in Minsk. In the meantime, my aunt, my father's sister, passed away. And I heard that I have a cousin, Bella, she lives in Minsk, so I came. So I said to Nesiva Sholem, I'm going to visit my cousin in Minsk, and maybe I have a chance to be in Slonim and Branovich. And Nesiva Sholem said to me, you go off to Warsaw, to the Divrei Shmuel, please take the book of all the names, and you will say all the names, but the cave from Divrei Shmuel in Warsaw, the Divrei Shmuel was buried in Warsaw. Because for some reason they was in Warsaw, and he became sick and couldn't, he was nikva in the oil in the Beis HaKvoros in Poland and Warsaw. So this was the reason what I went to visit my cousin, her mother and my father with brother and sister. So this was the reason that I went to Warsaw. I will show it here in the screen. seeing from Divya Shmuel. And this chance I had was able also to visit Minsk and Slonim and Branich. What was the few words about the Divya Shmuel? The Divya Shmuel was in a time, was a terrible time for young Jewish boys and girls. The Haskalah became up, and new systems, came, and then, like today, the young people, sometimes as they go, young people, boys and girls, used to the nicer family used to go away from the way, and was against, and the Divya Shmuel found a way, Mesirus Nefesh, to be mekarev these young people. They was coming to his tish on Shabbos with a cigar, was against the tish, and the Divya Shmuel had patience, and it was mekarev, my dear, I love you, I like you, the young boys and the young girls. It was wonderful, wonderful matzliach in this hard time for you Jewish young people. And he was also from Vamdiv and built in this time, they decided to build up Judas Israel. He was with all the Gdolim in this time, together, and he was miyased in this time, the Judas Israel, also for the time was the need, good to be together, unity. And everybody was mechaved in respecting and love the Divya Shmuel. Just now, it was the Yortzeit, Yotet Shvat, the last month, the outside from Divya Shmuel. Two my friends, two young alive, they are grandsons from the Birkas Avraham Weinberg, two brothers. They went specially to the seal, to the grave, to the oil in Divya Shmuel in Warsaw, and they came back and they told me that when they came in, they were feeling as like a ganeg, especially oil, because they couldn't understand why. Just now, Yotet Shvat, the last Yotet Shvat, they went to this place, and they were feeling like a ganeg, from a musarach. So, now, I want to say only one word more, and then we'll start. Maybe we've shown you know the Bikur in Tafshin Nun Gimel. So put it next. This is Rabbi Yoskovich, the Rav from Warsaw this time, and he gave me the key and how to go to the Beis Solom. This is the entrance for the shul in Warsaw. So this was a small minyan in this time, for 20 years ago. I was in the joined the people in the shul in Warsaw. Go next. This is a street in Warsaw this time. And this is a terrible, this called, the place called Umschlagplatz. But the Holocaust, all the Nazis took all the Yidden in this place, in this corner, the Umschlagplatz. And from this place, they took all the Yidden to the Macht, to the Rallagers, to kill them. So I was staying there, this time I was praying, and it was familiar structures to be in this place, and it was all over. Millions of years from Poland was taken in the concentration lagers. This is the entrance to the oil for Divya Shmuel. Wait, yeah, go farther. Yeah, this is the Tzion. The say outside. This is the, you can see it. There is a rock. The Divya Shmuel. But right there, you fast fire, right? Both inside. This is inside in the oil. This I found in the oil a lot of kvitlach. I don't know who put it inside. This was kvitlach for Yidden that came to the grave. This is the candle that I think of the oh. This is what's finished with Divya Shmuel. The next stop in this trip was Maranovich. All the houses from Maranovich was burned was from wood. Only one exists was from stone, is the yeshiva from Rabbi Chonah Wasserman. The yeshiva is called, I saw you, your today this pinyin is a school for sport. Later on the second trip I will explain you more. So this is inside the school, the sport school, but this was the shul from the Torah, from the Yeshiva from the Rechon Abasserman. Hashem in Kol Domo. This is the people upstairs. Wow. Again the Yeshiva.
That was probably Ezra's
last. This is street in Branovich. Also street in Branovich.
This is Russian?
Russian, Belarus.
White Russia.
Also street there. Also a street. This is Slonim. Slonim, 20 years ago,
afternoon Gimel.
1994.
93. 21 years ago, Yeah. This is Slonim. This is the street of Slonim. This is Beis Oimo, Beis Akvores, in Slonim. There are three graves. Short. This is the middle one is Sota Boide, all Slonim Rebbe. And the right side is the Beis Avrom, his grandside. And the brother on the left side is Yisachar Leib. Three graves in Slonim. Also thrown in this same place. And also there. This was in Minsk 20 years ago. It was a very small people was dancing and give chizuk. Was no Yidden there. The Koshi song, I met my cousin there this time, was a very, very excited.
This is the cousin you went looking for?
Yeah.
Oh.
It was the ghetto in Minsk. He was killed, my friend's father was killed in this ghetto here. Now it's Branovich Tavshin Ayin Gimel.
Oh.
20 years later. I came again. What was the reason? I must tell you, what was the reason that I came again? 20 years I was not there. And now I came again. What the reason? Somebody, a friend, came to our shul last Pesach, to our Rebbe in Yerushalayim. He said to me, Chaim, you have a first cousin. Her name is Bella. She lives in Minsk. She's 62 years old, never married, from kosher tznius. Why you don't go to visit to her? I said, wow. I don't know. I didn't have any connection. 20 years. I don't know if she's alive, she's healthy. Don't worry, I will help you. He gave me the phone number for Rav Shneur Deitch. He's the shliach for Chabad in Minsk. I called him up, Chaim Eisenstadt from Yerushalayim. Do you know my cousin Bella? Sure I know her. Everybody knows her. I see her every day. So can you give me a phone number? I lost her. Sure I can give you. I called her, she speaks Hebrew in this time, this 20 years she learned Hebrew. Bella, Chaim, את רוצה שאני אבוא לבקר אותך? You want I should visit you? She said, כן, תבוא, please come. Ooh, this I felt is a history. 20 years I didn't see her, she's in life, she's full, she's 62, her mother, my father, brother, sister, my first cousin, why should not go to visit her? This was the last year after La Corona. I heard that from Amsterdam, they have a flight two times a week. Monday go from Amsterdam two and a half hour flight time. And Wednesday, they go back from Minsk to Amsterdam. So too, when I was in my shlichus in Amsterdam, I took the plane and I arrived in Minsk. The first day I came to the Beit Chabad of Shneur Deitch. This is a Beis Hamikdash. I don't know where there's such a lot of money. Beis Hamikdash, Beit Chabad, in Minsk. And he brought my cousin. I was so happy to meet her. A lady, 62, sneers, Shonotero Mitzvois, clever, smart. Everybody likes her. They call her Ima. Mom, they call her. Because she works for the Chabad, for the Koilel, the Litvish Koilel, and she bakes, she cooked. And I was so happy to meet her. Believe me, it's rapturous. I have such a hoshe of a cousin. So, and I don't know how she exists, 62. alone, the Yiddish, Shemotoyo. And this was the reason when I came again. So the second day was Tuesday morning. She took me on a 2:15 hours. From 7 in the morning till 10 in the night. With a guard, with Moret Derech. And she took me to Branovich, to Mush, Slonim, Kobrin, Lechavich. And that's what it was. In the beginning, I saw this a mitzvah to be a chazek. She knew that we would be interested for me because our background is longing, Kobrin. But Hashem gave me a gift. I took pictures, like here, I'm showing this for young people in Eretz Yisrael, in America, and they never heard. I bring them the atmosphere from 80 years, 100 years ago. This is a schus for me. This came out from this village. I'm going to show you now. This was. So the first stop was Banovich. Show, this is Banovich? Yeah. Oh, this is again the yeshiva on the Rechon of Wasserman. The Nesime Sholem is writing in his paper, Zichon Kodesh, wait a minute, he writes down the Branevich for the last stop from Rabbosein Abdoishim, from Lechavich, Kobrin, Slonim, when the younger Rabbi Shloim was killed in Branevich. And if, I want to share you the feeling what I have at this time. Rabbi Yudah Levi, right in the kingdom of the same teaching of Tzion, Hanot, Yishal, he said like this, Mi itneini meshotet v'mekoim asher niglo elokim lechonzayich v'letzirayich. Who will give me, I've come again to the air of Eretz Yisrael, the place where the Nevi'im and the Cholim had the Nevu'im from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He wants to be in the air, in this air. This air had the, don't have the Nevi'im now, but the air we have. This Hargoshe I had, Rabbi gave me the opportunity to be in this place where the old Slonim and Kubrin Lerich was starting, the big fire. What we have till now started in this place. No, it's nothing. No Yiddishkeit, no nothing. But the air are still there. But the fire was there. The Yerushalayim, the Hasidus, the only told the hard time that they have. So this was my feeling that I have the air. But like the place where this fire was resist. So I told you that the only one that left was the house from the Rechon of Wasserman Yeshiva, he also was killed. And this is a sign. Put on more sign. Oh, you can read bigger the next picture. Yeah, this is a sign from Banasi's Talmidim, from Rechon of Wasserman. It's right on his name here. And he said, also in English, he said, that in this and this year was killed the Rosh Hashiva, Rechon of Wasserman, all these Talmidim. And this is now on the wall for this school, the sports school in Branovich. Mm. So I want to tell you one word about the Rechon of Wasserman. You know what belonged to us, in Branovich used to be Moshe Midner. I don't know if he had the name. He was at the time from the base of Rome. He was like the Menahel of the Yeshiva. He was a big man. Moshe Midner was a Talmid Chochem, a Balat Voide, a man like 500 years ago. And the Rebbe Chon of Wasserman had a big kesher with Rebbe Moshe Midner, also with base of Rome. We used to learn together with Rebbe Chaim Brisker. Rebbe Chaim Brisker was also very close to Moshe Midner. So you know, I don't want to hold you too long, but the Levaye from Rebbe Moshe Midner, Rebbe Chon of Wasserman came to the Hesped. And he's saying, Hesped, I'm sure that Masechta Yevomis came from Olam HaElyon to be Melaver Rebbe Moshe Midner on his Levaye. Why? Because this is such a big yegiyah. He had the Masechta Yevomis, so he's sure that Masech the Yeromis came to be melaver the Bechon of Wasserman on his Levi. This was the Bechon of Wasserman. And this was, in the meantime, gold. I came in Branovich, I saw
Do you want me to read what it says in English?
You can read it in English, I don't see it so much. You'll read it in English.
This building was founded by the Branovich local Jewish community around 1930 for their famous yeshiva of El Torah. The yeshiva was established in 1907 and was destroyed by the Nazis in 1941. It was leaded by Rabbi Elkanah Bolin Wasserman and had 300 students when World War II started. In 1939, the yeshiva was closed by the Russian government. Rabbi Elkanah escaped to Kovna with part of the students.
Okay, that's so go with the This is the place.
So what was the building?
Still,
the building's in use, but there's no Jews there.
No, the building is now a school for sports. This place is today the main. So this place they took all the Yidden from Branovich, maybe also the young Rebbe and all the Slonim Hasidim and everybody. To this place they took it to kill them, to verbrenn them. So still now, they say, I think in Russia, and I was staying and remember what happened in this place. This is the central of Branovich, and it was taken all the Yidden, they say in Russia, they took, the Nazis took away all the Yidden from this place in Branovich. So the second stop was Mush. You say, Hoba Mush. In Russia, it means, still now they have the same name. Branovich, Mush, Kobri, Lechavich, Slonim, still now they have the same name. Still have not the same. So here they said, Haba Mush, the new Mush. So this was close to Branovich, and the Rav was Rabbi Yechiel Mush. This is a grave. The Rav from Mush was called Rabbi Yechiel Mush. Was a big tzaddik, a palmit from Lechavich Kobri, and after Mush, he was nifter, so everybody went back to Branovich. But I want to tell you about Mush. So in his time, you should understand what is something about him. Was a terrible fire in Mush. Till today, most of the houses in Branovich are from wood. And the fire burned up one house and second house and third house and fourth. Many houses in Mush was burned up. So the people came to the Rav, please, what the whole city is going. No Mush more. What can we do? Please pray for us. He said, don't worry. Don't worry. I'll tell you something, not a hefker. Pamalia Shelmalo is sitting now and is down of eat. Spendel means it's wood. What should burn or should not burn? Not hefker. Be quiet. We're sitting in the heaven in the dawn of every. Be quiet and we'll stop and don't worry. This is his was a chibush. So I remember 20 years ago in Yerushalayim, when the Tzibbe Sholem was the time for the rabbin. Wants to give back Aza was Oslo, Eskem Oslo, 20 years ago. So the Nesiv Sholem was very worried. He should not give back. Aza Goyim said, Aza, the Jewish people are not living there, we can give back. But the Nesiv Sholem, no. He said, it's Israel. Why should give back what they are? In the end, he said, he told this story for the Chilmush about this Sefer. He said, also today, I'm sure that Palmalia Shalmalo is sitting in his dawn of each piece from Eretz Yisrael, if should give back the Arab or not. We do not have care. We don't have to worry. We have to trust Hashem is done now. Quiet of each piece of Eretz Yisrael, what they should give or should not give. So I'm an Anias Gaita, I'm a very small man, but I think Anias Gaita today also, in Eretz Yisrael, the town today more give back in Eskemin, in Arabim, and they want to give back more. I think we have to use this wonderful. I'm sure Anias Gaita, the Talmud also, the Palmar Yeshemano is sitting in heaven and is down of each piece in Eretz Yisrael. What we should give, what should not give, we don't have to worry. We have to trust Hashem that everything should be okay. Kach nireh l'anias dalek. Nishkin efker, no efker. So the third tachana, third was slonim. This is Rabbi Yochir Mush. This is slonim. The same, slonim tafshi nun gimel. This is the, on the...
Ayin gimel.
Say slonim, go more, next picture. Slonim. Oh, this, you will not believe what this. This is the entrance, a shul, a synagogue in Slonim 100 years ago. You will not believe how this exists till now. The Nazim and the Communistim did destroy anything. Inside, you will see two pictures. It's unbelievable. Everything is like what used to be 100 years ago. Let's show inside. This is outside the synagogue. And get the entrance.
Whoa.
This is inside, on Kodesh. Look more. We say, this exists now. Now in Slonim, all true. Look more. Inside. Can you believe it? Somebody gave it at Slav, a Roshe, but it should exist. Till now, we're not using it, but inside it's unbelievable. 100 years ago, there's also inside. Why? Can you believe it?
Yeah.
Marvelous. Look at this. This is a chair. I don't know what it means. This is the again the Mekom Beis HaKvoros.
Does that show have a name?
No, I don't know. I don't know the Slonim. Slonim used to use it 100 years ago. This is the Beit Soilon. It's only three graves inside now. Look more. This is what I said, told you before. The Soil Avoide, and the right side Beit Avrom, and the left side Beit Avrom. I took two the candles on, I got maskir, I got body. Doch Klal Yisroel was praying, was very disruptive there. But for me, a big disruption. This is, you say, this is Rav Weinberg, the son of Voide. This is the city, this is the base of Rome. And this is the whole thing. Three graves. This is Slonim. Everything is Slonim.
Abraham Weinberg is the
son of Voide. This is the start, the number four, Kobri.
I just want to say that my father's mother and her family
came from Kobri. This is Kobri. This is far away, but 2 hours by car.
Wow.
The rabbi's grandfather came from Kobri. Grandmother came from Kobri.
Wow.
And this is very far, but 2 hours by car. Let's say Kobri. The way to Kobri. Also an old shul. But I... Ryan said it was a shul, said a year, I don't know exactly what year, but it was closed, so I took pictures only from outside. I was not able to go, but it told me that inside the shul exists, it could all shul in Kobrin, I know many years. So I took around this building. You see?
Mm.
This is a...
Wow.
What did you say? Oh, this is the Beis HaKvoros in Kobrin. I was able to be. It's a grave, it's a fixing now. It's only the oil. But it was, they know exactly where the oil was. So I came to the oil, not close to here, and I put the candle. I was feeling. I'm in Kobrin. I cannot believe this is what for me exciting, unbelievable. You see the oil. It's again the Matzeve.
Can you read?
This is the oil.
Go back. That's the oil.
The oil from Moishin Kobrin. Kobrin alone. Moishin Kobrin. lighting candles. Difficult.
That's a mushroom.
Mushroom wings, very great.
It's more material.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Not material. They fix him up. No, there'll be a new material. They fix him up.
Cemetery destroyed by the.
No, the cemetery is still many matzeves, but the grave is now, they're fixing up the matzeves. I saw many matzeves there on the entire in Kobri.
Is your cousin taking these pictures?
Yeah, I take the pictures.
But not of yourself?
Yeah, my cousin, Garde, Meraderech. Now is the last stop, Lechavitch. Wait a minute, let's go back. This is Lechavitch. Oh, stay a minute. The Lechavitcher says, I throw a pzatza, a bomb, I throw in Kobrin, but this will fire till Mashiach will come. That means the Hasidus, the fire for Lechavitch, is thrown in Kobrin, and this fire will exist till Mashiach will come. That's what the Lechavitcher said. So I was seeing in this place Kobrin, but then the fire, this means in Kobrin, the fire is still Mashiach. So now I came to Lechavitch. I was asked if Mashavit Borach should be for me a miracle, it was almost evening. I should be able to arrive Lechavitch before the Shkia. I should be able to daven a minche in Lechavitch, because it was always night. And Hashem was listening to my prayer. I didn't just arrive in Lechavitch before Shkia. And the first tree, what I saw, I can stay. So I was praying mincha there with great structures, like I said before. I'm in Lechavitch, the air from Lechavitch. I'm praying a mincha. And you know, this is very important. The Lechavitch has said that if you want to check a yid or a chosid, how big is the Yiddo Shamayim, you should look how he's done the mincha. Shach is many to go around. Mincha is a... you want to check the Yiddish mind and the Hasidus from the Yiddish, you should look how is it done in Minche. This is very important. So Minche for me was so important to daven a kavone Minche in Lechavitch. Unbelievable. So we came after this to a street, a Jewish street. We found a goye, old woman. She was born in Lechavitch, and she said, I will take you, and you know that this street, but all the Yidden would live in this street. Rechov HaYehudim is called. The street of the Jewish people. So I was so happy to be in this street. It's also this street. So now, before we came to Minsk, I would like to tell you one thing was very important for us. Listen to me. Very much. The Kobrin went the Shlichus from his Rebbe de Lechavitch to collect Eretz Yisroel. This means to collect money for the people who are sitting and learning in Din HaKadosh Baruch Hu in Eretz Yisroel. Very holy. It's called Ma'ot Eretz Yisroel. Eretz Yisroel. So he sent them the Shlichus. When Moshe Kobrin went out from his place to this shliches, the Sitre Achle, the Malach, the Samach Mem, the Baldova came to him. He said, Moshke Kerzach Moshke, you go back. Moshke Kerzach The Sitre Achle told him, don't go. Go back. So the Moshe Guri said, don't worry. I have a Kabbalah for my Rebbe. That was the Samach Mem, when the Sitrachi said, we have to do the opposite. You tell me I should go back? No, I'm not going back, because I have Kabbalah, don't listen. What you say to me, I do the opposite. And second, he said, I kill you, I will burn you. He said, I don't worry. I'm going with Rus, my Rebbe Mordechai ben Edel, Lechavitch of course, and I don't worry. So the Samach Mem saw, he cannot do nothing to him. They left us. So I think, and he has died today also. Everybody from us, we have a shlichus. Doesn't mean I need a brand. We are here, we are there, we are. Sometimes Missionaries, we had a call, Moshe Kerzachum, go back, don't do it. We have to be strong today to say no. I do the opposite. What we said, I should give back, I'm not going back. I continue learning and davening and doing chesed. Today is also this world, we have to use it. So now I came back to the Minsk, this is the finish in a few minutes. So Minsk was a big city from also I saw there, and I say that we will see this in Shul. Listen now, we have a yeshiva, and Miss Amiga told you before, Beit Chabad. Very unbelievable. This is a shluch in Chabad, Beit Chabad. This is the Minsk. And now it's a beautiful city. Minsk became rich. All the going wanted to rent, to be in, because it's a very, very, very nice city now, Minsk. A big change. And you, this is it, this is Minsk. Minsk. Speak in Minsk. Everything in Minsk. Unbelievable.
No people
there. Oh, this is also Matzeve. Put today, and Matzeve called in Yiddish that they were Nazim, the fascisten. Took all the Yid, maybe my grandfather took from this place to kill them in the ghetto. To mold them. So can you read it in Yiddish what they say? Can you say it? Say it loud. Who can read it in Yiddish? Say it loud. The fascists, they took away murder to the Yiddish people in this year and there. This was, this is a Matzev in Minsk. So, go more. This is the Matzev place. They also this same place. This is the feeling this year. This is a Moshe Midian that I told you before. Was close to Chonah Wasserman, to find Rivkin on the right side. And next to him staying the base of Rome, was the Rebbe from the city Sholem. So I want to, the message, finish this, what we show you. What is the message for us now? What we have to have for this all of the song now? This, the fire and the This big ruach is still continue and exist till today. If all the nisyonos what they have, the private and the beklal, everybody's nisyonos. Okay, sorry, verschiedene people are not sleeping because who knows what will be the panose, shiduchim, refues. What will be with Obama, what will be with Dr. Teran, Netanyahu, we not sleep. No. We don't have to worry. We have to know that Abba Shemaim are sitting and keeping us, and we don't have to worry. We have to think only today. But you who don't have a Dagis Mocho, and be strong, and don't listen what you have Moshe Kerzachum. We will continue our work, Besimche, Bemune, Besimche, ובתוכן, ABC, אמונו בתוכן שמחה, ABC, אמונו בתוכן שמחה. This is your question, this is ABC, אמונו בתוכן שמחה. אמן, אמן, אמן. That this will bring us the כורב, the גאולה שלמו, ושליים, אמן ואמן.
אמן,
אמן.
No picture of your wonderful cousin?